Hi, my lovely beading people. How are you today? Today I want to show you how to make the ring to go with this bracelet. I put this bracelet in a photo tutorial. You can see it there, but the ring we're going to make is the same technique. So if you don't like to learn from a photo tutorial, you can also just watch this tutorial and then make the bracelet after seeing this one. So let's start. The things you need: a long piece of thread, about 2.5 arm span, I think. It can be a little bigger. You need some tiller beads. You need some 15-0 beads, some 11-0 beads, and two needles. I don't know if you can see them, but two needles. So I recommend using something on your thread to making it a little bit smooth. I used beeswax. I think that it works fine, and I use sealon. You can also use fire line if you like, just what you like the most. So I'm going to zoom in a little. So let's start. First of all, we're gonna pick up a tiller bead. Just thread it on and bring it to the middle. Like that. Then we're going to pick up on one side, one 15-0, one 11-0, and one 15-0. And we're going to put that in the next hole of the tiller bead. I'm going to zoom in a little better. Like that. Oh. Like that. And pull it through. Like that. Now you're going to do the same thing on the other side. So take your needle, pick up a 15-0, an 11-0, and a 15-0, and thread it through the second hole of the tiller bead. Like that. And pull it. Now it looks like this. Pick up another tiller bead and crisscross your needles in it. And then you pull it. Now we're first gonna work on this side. So I'm picking up the beads and I'm picking up one 15-0, one 11-0, and one 15-0, and stick it to the next top of the tiller bead. Like this. Now leave that needle alone, pick up the other needle, pick up one 15-0, one 11-0, and one 15-0, and stick it through the next hole of the tiller bead. Like this. Again, pick up a tiller bead and crisscross your needles in it and pull it. Like that. First on one side, pick up a 15-0, an 11-0, and a 15-0, and stick it through the next hole on the tiller bead. Like that. Leave that needle alone. Pick up your other needle, pick up one 15-0, one 11-0, and one 15-0. Stick it to the second hole of the tiller bead and pull. And as you can see, we have now three tiller beads on. This is what you are going to continue doing until you have a piece that's long enough to fit your finger. I'm going to make my piece, and after I've done that, I will come back. Now, I made it that long so it fits my finger. And now we're going to attach the side where you stopped to the side where you started. So you're going to take your needle, one needle at a time, and stick it through the tila bead at the end. Not through the 15-0 beads, but only through the tila bead. Like this. And then you grab it and go the other way. Like that, and pull it, and then you're going to secure it by making this round about 2 to 3 times. So that was one, and this is two. I think we leave it at two, because in this way the other thread can go through also. So leave it at there. Take the other needle and stick it through like that. And this is one time, and this is two times. So, well, now your work is closed. Now I'm going to make the attachment between the tila beads. So we're coming out of the tila bead at the end. And we're going to start first with your right or your left. At least start at one point and keep doing that point first. So I'm going to pick up 2 15-0s. 1 11-0 and 2 15-0s. Like that. I hope you can see them. And then you're going to stick your needle at the opposite side of the second tila bead. Like this. Like this. When you pull it, you can see that the beads are overlapping the little gap between the tila beads. Like that. Then we're going to take the needle and stick it through the next 3 beads on the side. Like this. And I'm going to take the last one with it, going to the through the tila bead at the end. So that's the second hole of the tila bead we just went out of, and pull it. And then we're going to leave that needle there, and we're going to take the second needle, and we put on 2 15-0s, go through the middle bead. So that's the 11-0 bead in the middle, like that, and pull it. Then we're going to take another 2 15-0s, and we're going to stick the needle through the first hole of the tila bead. So that's to the other side. Like that, and pull it. And make sure if you pull it that you arranged the beads in the way you like it. Then go through the next 3 beads and pull, and then go through the tila bead. Did you see that? I didn't know you could see. So I went to through the 3 beads and then downwards. Oh. And then downwards through the tila bead, like that. So, as you can see, Now you have a little crust over the spaces between the tila beads. Like that. Now we're going to start all over again. We're going to start at this side. You're going to take 2 15 0's, 1 11 0, and 2 15 0's. Stick it in the next tiller bead at the first hole. Like that. Oh, I'm sorry. Like that. And pull it through. Like that. And then go through the next three beads. That were the next two, but I will take that with it when I go through the tila bead. And don't forget that you don't want the other beads to you don't want to go through the other beads as well, because it will look a little bit crooked. So now leave that needle alone. Pick up the other needle. Pick up 2 15 0's. And go through the 11 0 in the middle. Give it a little tug. Like that. Pick up 2 15 0's. Stick your needle through the first hole of the tila bead. Like that. And go through the next three beads. Like that. And stick it down through the second hole of the tila bead. In this way you can see that your crust is going to be the same. And you're going to continue doing this until you are all around. So I'll be back. I'm going to do this and I'll be back when I finished it. And then I can show you how it looks. And after I showed you that, I'm going to show you how to make a double ring or a double bracelet. It's very easy, but there are a few little steps that are different. So I finished my ring. I have to say, I didn't do it all the way, because I liked how it turned out. I really liked it, the three X's. It looks like little kisses, and as if you have a kisses ring. So I like it this way. So I leave this this way. Now for the next project, this one. This one is very easy to make also. This is just two bracelets attached to each other. So what you have to do if you want to make this, first of all, what you have to do, you make one bracelet, and depending on how many strands next to each other you want, you're going to make the bracelet and then attach another one on it. And if you want to make three, you can also just make two bracelets and then attach the middle one. So show you how to make another one on this one. So that's not the technique you would use if you want to make three, but I'm going to show you how to attach a second one on the one you already made. So for this part, you're going to pick up 2 15 0's. Oh, sorry, I threaded two needles, so you need two needles. You pick up 2 15 0's, 1 11 0, 1 15 0, 1 11 0, and 2 15 0's. That is the way to start the bracelet. like that. And then put them in the middle. I'm just using a little thread here because I'm just going to show you what to do. So, there you have it. Take a tiller bead and crisscross your needles in it. Like that. You see, this is the start for the bracelet. Like that. Now, lay it against your first bracelet. And I'm gonna zoom in a little so you can see just a little better. Like that. Hope I don't get out of focus. So what you're going to do, pick up with the needle on the side of the other bracelet, pick up 1/15 and I'm going to pick this up and put your needle through the 11-0, the first 11-0. Can you see that? Like that. Pick up another 15-0. I'm going to lay this flat now and put it through the next hole of the tila bead. Like that. And pull it. You can see that you normally you would pick up a 15-0, an 11-0 and a 15-0. Now they're just sharing the 11-0. Now, we're gonna leave that needle aside. We're gonna pick up the other needle. And you're going to pick up 1/15-0, 1/11-0, and 1/15-0. And you're going through the second hole of the tila bead. And pull. Pick up another tila bead and crisscross your needles in it. Like that. And pull it. Now you're going to do the same thing you just did. So you're going to start at the side where you have to attach the first bracelet to the second bracelet. Pick up a 15-0 and go through the 11-0. I hope I don't do this too fast, but I think this isn't a hard bracelet to do, so I think you get what I do. Then pick up an 15-0 and stick it through the top of the tila bead and give it a little tug. Pick up one with the other needle, pick up 1/15-0, 1/11-0 and 1/15-0, like that. And stick it through the top of the tila bead. And now pull it. Now again, pick up a tila bead, crisscross in it, pick up a 15-0, go through the 11-0, pick up a 15-0, go through the tila bead on the top side. And then pick up the other needle, do the other side, like this one. And do that until you are all the way up. So I'm going to do that now, and then I'm going to show you how you go back and make the little crosses in the middle of the tila beads. So as you can see, I'm now at the top, and I'm going to turn over my work, like that. So, and now I'm going to pick up my work. Because that's a little bit easier for me. I hope you can see all the things I do. I come out of the top of the, of this is the bottom now, of the tila bead. And I'm going through the next 15-0 bead. And the next 11-0 bead. And the next 15-0 bead. And then I'm going down through the tila bead. So I'm making a turn so I can start making the rest of the embellishment. So I'm going to do that on the other side also. So I hope you can see. I'm going through the beads and I will reach the other side of the tila bead like that. Give it a little tug so it's nice and tight. And then we're going to just do the same as we would do on a normal bracelet. Pick up 2 15-0s, 1 11-0, 2 15-0s, and stick it the opposite side on the second tila in the first hole. I hope you can see that. I have to look up like that. And I'm going through the first hole. I'm going through the first 15-0 bead here, through the 11-0 bead. And through the 15-0 bead, and then in one way through the tila, the second part of the tila. Then I'm taking my other needle, thread on 2 15-0 beads, then through the 11-0 bead. Pick up 2 15-0 beads and go through the first hole of the tila bead through the other side. And I'm going through the first bead also. And through the through the 3 beads on the side. And then through the tila bead to the other side. So you can see that is just the same. I'm not going to finish this one because I'm going to deattach this and also the ring. I'm going to deattach that because I'm going to use the tilas for something else. This was just for the tutorial. But as you can see, it works just the same, only because this part doesn't have an 11-0 bead of itself. You have to go through the 11-0 bead that you share. That's the only thing, and it looks very nice also on the back. You can see on the back also it looks very slick. So that's the tutorial for today. I hope you liked this tutorial. I have to say it was a little bit hard for me to make because I wanted to stay in focus. And that is something that is a little bit difficult. I do this for the first time. Let me know what you think of my lightning for beading tutorials. Crafting tutorials are a little bit more easy to film because you can film a bigger piece of the table, but for this I really have to zoom in to show you all the beads. So please tell me, can you see all the beads? Can you see all the steps that I'm doing? Is it clear? I hope you understand it. If you didn't understand it, I'm sorry. I did make a photo tutorial, so if you didn't get anything, please ask me or go and see my photo tutorial. I hope this tutorial was clear. I wish you a very nice day, and to the next time. Bye!